本周四，在北京召开的全国人大会议将通过这个港版的国家安全法。上周五，这项决定草案已经公布，正文共有七个条款。纽约大学法学院教授孔杰荣说，其中最令人担忧的是第四条，该条款的目的就是直接在香港设立大陆国安系统的机构。
That means instead of having the existing situation whereby quietly, usually indirectly, the Communist Party of China controls the Hong Kong government administration, there will be public overt central government institutions going beyond the current institutions representing the liaison office and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. These new agencies will be public security agencies. They will be under the control of the Ministry of Public Security in Beijing, and probably also the Ministry of State Security, of National Security from Beijing. That means direct control of public order, of freedom of speech, of criminal justice in Hong Kong. And you can see why this is a mortal blow against the declining one country, two systems. This may really be the death warrant for Hong Kong.
美国驻香港总领事杨苏蒂大使认为，北京想在香港推动国安立法并不新鲜，新的是为什么要在现在推出？他认为其中有陷于经济政治困境的习近平想转移国内视线的因素。
Because Xi Jinping's economy is slowing down or even gone into negative growth, and his ambition to be president for life is going to be in some jeopardy as other members of the leading, the Politburo look and see what's going on and wonder if she's actually fumbling the ball a little bit. So they're pushing something they don't have to push at a time when there's lots of other problems on their plate. The best I can imagine is that Xi Jinping is in trouble domestically for the reasons I've stated, and he feels he needs to distract his people and his opponents by creating this adventure in Hong Kong, but I think it's going to end badly.
杨苏蒂大使说，北京的这一立法举动已经并将继续激起香港人更大规模的抗议浪潮。孔杰荣教授担心，这将会造成更大的人权灾难。
You'll see many arbitrary detentions, arrests, convictions, and sentences under the forthcoming arrangement with national security legislation imposed on Hong Kong. Hong Kong is going to look more and more like the other cities of China, and people are going to be reduced to the same degree of suppression of their liberties that other people in China have been subjected to.
美国香港民主会负责人杨锦霞承认，港版国安法带来的打压会更严厉，但他表示这吓不倒香港人。
这一里面我们看到，你越是逼他们，他们没有说就是因为我怕你去逮捕，我怕你去给我去坐监狱，我就不出来。你们会看到这些年轻人的心里面，因为他们说 this is it， 我一个activist 跟一个老师来说，还有一个妈妈来说，一个身份来说，对人对这些手足是非常的痛惜他们，但是我们也去了解他们为什么这样去做。
杨锦霞表示，更大的压迫只会令他们更努力地在美国国会进行游说工作。美国之音方冰九岛纽约报道。